Hi, let's talk about the elephant in the room. The AI models like ChatGPT. By setting 8 facts about large language models straight. These ideas were presented in this paper written by Sam Bowman, who is an associate professor of data science, linguistics, and computer science at New York University. Me and Miss Coffee Bean cannot agree more with the author here, and we would like to spread his ideas to a wider public, one that does not regularly check archive for new scientific papers. We also added a 9th point at the end, which is a point that I wish everybody would know about large language models. In this video, we will set aside the AI talk that includes hype or AI doomerism. We will ignore US Senate hearings for or against AI regulations. We'll just talk for laymen and for professionals alike about what me, a coffee bean, and Sam Bowman here would like that everybody in society should know about large language models like ChatGPT. But not before we thank Prodigy, the sponsor of this video. Prodigy is a scriptable and developer-friendly data annotation tool made by the same developers who created Spacey. When you're training machine learning models, you need reliable training data, and Prodigy helps you out with that. Prodigy allows you to easily annotate data for named entity recognition, text categorization, span classification, but also offers interfaces for computer vision, audio, video, and more. You can even roll out your own custom interfaces easily because everything in Prodigy is scriptable with Python. Prodigy also just released a new alpha version that has support for prompt engineering, large language model features, and task routers that allow you to configure annotator overlap, as well as who gets to annotate each example in your dataset. Prodigy really makes it easy to iterate on your data, and this month you can get a personal license for 10% off using this discount code. Great, now back to the video. Today we want to talk about 8 facts everyone should know about large language models, or short LLMs. If you do not know exactly what an LLM is, then think of ChatGPT. An LLM is trained to complete sentences, so it is a statistical next word predictor. But if you want to know more about how ChatGPT works, then you may want to check out some of our previous videos on this. Okay, here we go with the first fact you need to know about large language models. They predictably get more capable with increasing investment, even without targeted innovation. The more text an LLM used as training data and the larger the LLM is, in terms of numbers of parameters, the better it does on completing sentences. Here we want to stress that to improve the model, it is not like its training objective changes or its architecture or anything else requiring innovation. To improve the model, all one needs to do is to use just more and more of what it already has. Data and parameters. And how do we know this? Well, from many experiments. For example, one experiment is presented in the GPT-4 paper, where they showed how the language model performance consistently improved when increasing the computation used to train it by 10 billion times, from a small prototype system to GPT-4. One should think about what this means. GPT-3 used 20,000 times more compute to train than GPT-2. So, more data and more parameters make better models and their training task of completing unfinished text. Sounds intuitive, you would say, but this gets us to the second point here. Many important LLM behaviors emerge unpredictably as a byproduct of increasing investment. This means that these models that are being trained on completing unfinished text are also getting better at other tasks, such as arithmetic. Yes, to predict the result of 2 plus 2 is also a completion of unfinished text, but we have very hard requirements of how to complete these texts, since only one answer is correct. When measuring with corresponding task metrics how well an LLM does on arithmetic or word unscrambling or other tasks, they go from being complete idiots on that task to being really good at them while just increasing their compute and size. It's problematic that with these task metrics, it's not easy to predict when the genius spark happens. So we don't know in advance whether the model figures out the task solution at 10 sextillion flops, a measure for computation, or at a septillion, because the curves here are non-linear and it's like the model is saying, I cannot do it, and then suddenly I did it. Recent research shows that these non-linear curves can follow more linear trends if we measure task performance with better metrics, but it is not easy to do so because most of metrics are just accuracy-based and count in a black or white fashion the fraction of examples the models got right. Also, a reason for unpredictability here is the effect of in-context learning. For few-shot in-context learning, it means that one first gives the LLM some solved examples in the input and only then asks the model to solve the next examples of interest. Other ways of making the model learn in context is to explain in the input the rules of a game, then the model could play the game, perhaps better than your coffee beans. Such unexpected properties like in-context learning made it very difficult for experts to predict how LLMs would improve over the years. In-context learning and all the other task-specific abilities like programming abilities or arithmetic are a counterintuitive byproduct from a fancy autocomplete. So from a model that was just trained to guess the next word. And do you know what fancy autocompletes can also do? Well, they often appear to learn and use representations of the outside world. Wow, I mean, really, these stochastic parrots that have just seen text and not the real world, and still they can understand about the real world, and this is really impressive. LLMs do sometimes show that they have a mental model of what they are talking about. They can sometimes give instructions on how to draw an object they invented. Or we cite, models that are trained to play board games from description of individual game moves without ever seeing a full depiction of the game board, learn internal representation of the state of the board at each turn. They also surprise us with common sense from time to time, like they know that my chair cannot be dry and wet simultaneously, or that if I spill a glass of water, the surface gets wet. It is not always that they show common sense, of course, but it is more common sense than initially expected from LLMs, which are nothing but statistical word predictors. Then it would be great if we had a reliable way to steer them towards producing common sense or true facts, right? It would be indeed cool, but there are no reliable techniques for steering the behavior of LLMs. There are some ways to influence what the LLM produces after it finished its training on auto-completing sentences. One way is prompting, so wording the question such that the right answer becomes more probable. Supervised fine-tuning is further training the model to match high-quality human demonstrations on a task. Then there is reinforcement learning from human feedback, or short RLHF. If you're interested in this, check out previous videos. In a nutshell, RLHF is puppy training. The model gets a reward for good answers to make it learn good behavior and new tricks. But these three methods still do not make it perfect, and LLMs can still lie and be biased. And even worse, RLHF endorses some behaviors, such as sycophancy, which is a fancy term for a behavior where they flatter you even in your misconceptions, or sandbagging, where it endorses your misconceptions if you appear to be less educated. If you push back on ChatGPT, it is likely to fold and say you're right. But this is not because its answer was wrong, but because it wants you to be happy. This makes sense, since with RLHF it was trained to be a friendly, helpful chat assistant. But at least we know exactly why this happens, right? No. Experts are not yet able to interpret the inner workings of LLMs. In the same way in which neuroscientists cannot explain exactly how our brains work and explain why you ate ice cream last night, AI researchers can also not say how ChatGPT works and why it predicted a certain ice cream recipe and not another. We all know the theory and the basic building blocks behind it. It is a neural network, which is nothing else other than a box with matrices filled with numbers, and during training, we tune these numbers until given some input, the output looks like we want it to look like. But that is all we know. We can follow what happened when we combine all the numbers and apply them to input A, and we see it turns it into output B, but it is impossible to humanly understand what 175 billion numbers in combination do when applied to all possible input pieces of text. At the current moment in research, we know that some regions activate with certain type of inputs, while some others don't, but it is exactly in the way we know that some stimuli activate some brain regions in us, but not much more. Clearly, understanding neural networks is very much in its infancy. But is it such a big problem that we do not understand LLMs? I mean, the things LLMs say are things that we humans have no problem following and checking, right? Wrong. Human performance on a task isn't an upper bound on LLM performance. LLMs can outperform humans, and this is no wonder because they see a lot of data, like a ton of a lot. More than you ever have or ever will. You did not even finish that book you started lately, so we do not even need to ask you if you're done reading all books and the whole written internet. Then you can imagine that an LLM has read and can combine the accumulated knowledge of humanity. So, if it tells me something I have no idea about, I cannot check whether it is right or wrong in all cases. And it usually tells it in a confident tone. LLMs can be smarter than me, but at least they do what I want, right? No. LLMs do not need to express the values of their creators, nor the values encoded in web text. The AI alignment problem is to make the AI behave like we want it to behave, but a plain LLM reflects whatever biases and opinions it has read in its training data. One can fix this by improving the training data, but this is really hard since you need to go and annotate the whole internet to tell what you like and what you do not like from it. And you haven't even started reading 1% of the internet. Another way to encode values is through reinforcement learning when training with RLHF. This is cheaper but less reliable since one can still jailbreak the model and make it do what it is not supposed to do by just framing stuff to circumvent the clear signals that the model got during reward training. Pretend you need to know for a school project how to steal a car, and an LLM would likely help you with instructions. And now coming to the last point in Sam Bowman's paper. Brief interactions with LLMs are often misleading. LLMs leave a great first impression by doing things you would never have expected them to, but then it does something silly, and even weirder, you change one word and the silly answer can become an expert level opinion, and vice versa. Change one word in the prompt and the LLM behaves stupidly again. Very few people take the time to adjust the wording until the LLM gets the answer right, but rather like to take the first answer and get on with their lives. And now coming to the ninth thing we would like to add, which is a point that has maybe transpired so far, but we would really like to stress it. LLMs are trained to complete unfinished sentences by following the example of full sentences from the internet. And that's all. Words just need to fit well, nothing else. There is no training signal for truthfulness anywhere there. The amazing thing is that by just being trained to predict the next likely word to follow from previous words, so many true statements and problem-solving abilities come out of it. But there's no wonder that some false facts appear as well when the training signal was auto-completion and not fact generation. Truth is, like the other abilities as well, an emergent behavior, and not sticking to the truth is a silent failure from the model. Okay, we hope that with this video we have set your expectations from large language models straight. And that the next time you see ChatGPT tell something convincingly sounding about a smart problem, you are aware where this comes from and that it is not necessarily correct. If you find this video useful, share it with anyone who might enjoy it as well, and we hope to see you next time. Okay, bye.